experience that they lost last week when Okorn went out and played against Indiana.
From the I formation, Davion Smith, out of Warren, Ohio, who promises to run hard and run.
He's coming more tonight than any time all year.
Hubbard's joined by Smith to his right on second and five. Barges up the middle and shows the acceleration. We'll see him making plays at a variety of positions, perhaps as many as 10.
Indiana got to have some wrinkles and do some things that they have not done in recent weeks.
They fake it from the pocket, flips it short. Jake Butt, the All-American tight end candidate, is running free up near midfield for another first down before Marshawn Lattimore drove him out.
Ohio State actually ends up bringing a blitz here. On the left, you'll see the linebacker. See, he gets picked up, actually gets by the freshman, Redenson, and hits Spate for the first time. But because the linebacker came on the blitz, it's a nice big hole there in the zone. Nobody's there to pick up Jake Butt, who's one of the top targets on the Michigan offense.
And a big matchup concern today for that Ohio State defense. Diving across the 50-yard line is
put Michigan more of an aggressive mindset.
In second and 11, Spate rolls out, fires far side, short completion there to Amara Garbo, his top target on the
field, a senior who has great athletic ability and great speed.
Ohio State's been a tremendous third down defense. Wolverines need four to keep this opening drive alive. Protection, delivers a low throw, incomplete. Butt tried to go down and get it, but it hit the carpet. And it's in second possession for Michigan from the 20. Again, it's Wilton Spate at quarterback. Davion Smith picks his way for a short gain. Raekwon McMillan and Damon Webb. Aaron Higdon is the back now in the I formation behind the fullback. And he flipped it short. This is Butt, who is well guarded right there, knocked down quickly by Jerome Baker, the linebacker. Michigan has not been a terribly efficient offense from this distance on third down so far this season. Spate, they block the pressure, complete. And off and running is Grant Perry out near midfield. Yards there in third and five. Now it's Peppers in the game at quarterback. Hands it off. He was a high school quarterback in New Jersey. He can
throw. And I'm telling you, at some point today, he's going to throw the football from the Wildcat package.
Higdon on the left side. This is the kind of game we've seen it over the years when a normally conservative four defensive ends in the game for Ohio State. They call themselves the Rushmen on third and seven. Spate gets protection, incomplete, delivered in traffic, falling down was Darbo, and it'll be fourth down. Harbaugh looking for the flag, doesn't see one.
Yeah, he was frustrated because Darbo, who was coming across, he got caught up with a couple Ohio State defenders. Much on the outside with Lattimore, you can see the physical push.
Oh my goodness.
Grabs him and throws him down. That was the reaction.
It was right in front of the bench.
Yeah, right. Exactly right.
Special teams could go a long way in determining who ends up winning this game.
52 yards on that punt. Wolverines from their 37. It's Darbo in motion. Spate looks back to the near side and delivers a strike. And the catch is made by Jay Chesson.
He looks so well prepared. He knows where to go with the ball before the ball actually gets into his hands on the snap.
Smith. Wow. McMillan. And Jalen Holmes dropped him for a short loss. Samantha?
Yeah, Kirk, to your point on Spate, they're going to get it out quick and try and take a deep shot down the field.
Now the Wolverines playing with some tempo on third down. Spate from the pocket delivers a nice throw into a tight window again to Grant Perry.
See the rhythm and the confidence that Spate has and the open windows that he has to throw in.
And off to the fullback. He's a short yardage specialist enough to get the first down. His long run is 4 yards, by the way. And first down is Spate. Straight back. Lots it. But goes up high, collects it, and makes the catch inside.
It's the third time they've thrown the ball on first and 10 on this drive alone.
On the end around. Johnson tries to cut back, and another little wrinkle there. That's a play that's hurt Ohio State. Oh. Smith slipped when he made the cut. Has to fight hard near first down yardage. Jerome Baker. On first and goal. Spate quickly back. Loops it for the end zone. A one-on-one battle, but against Damon Webb, the safety. No chance to make a play.
That is a thing.
Chris Evans, the true freshman you mentioned, Kirk, he's now the tailback in the eye on second and down, and he's got the ball, and he's going to have to escape and fight hard to get to the five-yard line. There was very quick penetration side this game, as they have so many others in this series. Peppers at quarterback. Keeps it. Tries to get the edge. Jabril Peppers knocked down for a loss again. It was Hubbard blowing the play.
Tendencies. And he sure has done that here in this first half.
And Spate has been very sharp. It's another first down attempt from the pocket. He delivers a high strike there. Kekoa Crawford, the true freshman.
To now, they look like a different team. They look like the team they looked like before the Iowa game, where they're much more aggressive and confident with their play calling.
Roll out on second and six. Spate delivers an accurate throw, and that's Chesson knocked out of bounds. They'll be short of a marker. And that's an incompletion. They're all over but that. These drives, unlike Ohio State. And Spate has been sharp. Chris Evans, the freshman, has to dodge traffic in the backfield. Wildcat quarterback on second and nine. He's yet to make an impact play on offense. And we'll run it right up into traffic. Ohio State's been preparing for what they've seen and what they haven't seen from Michigan involving number five.
It's almost
for Spate. There's the train formation, spotted on tape from a high school in Colorado. They try to keep the defense guessing in terms of the personnel. Spate chased immediately and hit, knocked down for the first time. Jerome Baker on the sack, and number three nursing that sore left shoulder goes to the ground for the first time.
We keep talking about Michigan blitzing on third down. Ohio State moves the nose guard, shoots Baker up the middle, and the right guard, Kalis, does not do a good job of recognizing that and coming down. It's a bust in the middle of that offensive line, and it's a good call by Luke Fickell to time that up on third down. Spate didn't have a chance.
You could see Kirk, the quarterback, trying to protect himself, turning his back to the tackle, keep that left shoulder protected, and don't want to take too many shots like that. His end zone, they fake it to him. Spate gets the throw away, intercepted, and another pick six for the Ohio State defense. Malik Hooker just walks in.
Boy, a gutsy call by Jim Harbaugh. Play action pass, which has worked most this game, but this time back deep into his own territory. And Ohio State brought pressure. They brought their linebackers, so Hooker comes up with a pick with his eyes on the ball. But the two linebackers, Baker and Raekwon McMillan, caused it.
Sixth pick for Hooker leads the team. And their seventh pick six of the season. Third for him, McMillan provided the pressure, and just like that, Ohio State, after a pretty dismal first half offensively, takes the lead with the defensive touchdown.
They bring the two linebackers. Baker's already walked up. McMillan's who ends up getting to the quarterback, but watch the running back and Smith and how unclear he is and what to do here. Ends up getting the pressure. Hooker's right here with his eyes on the quarterback. The ball just goes up in the air. And there's Hooker, who's been doing it all year. It's his third interception for a touchdown, seventh for Ohio State this year. And again, we talked at the beginning, special teams, turnover margin, that's what ultimately is going to decide this game. And the Buckeyes capture a huge break here.
So a risky call by Harbaugh in Michigan. And now the toss. Evans cuts it back, and the true freshman, just about 200 pounds, stopped by Hubbard. Back to Spate, and that trying to bounce back from that decision and that throw now.
I think the equity that he has in this season, I think it allows him to mentally put that behind him and move forward. I think if this were early in the year, the first-time starter, you start to doubt yourself and what's happening. But their plan has been pretty effective. He's got to put that behind him and now just try to execute and move the football.
It was only the ninth turnover this year by the Michigan offense, his fifth interception. They have not beaten themselves. But that's a tight throw. Darbo makes a dive so far for the Wolverines. They need six. Buckeyes rush four, but Spade is flushed and now delivers a strike. And coming back to the football was Darbo. They moved the sticks to the 40.
That throw two.
No, first down handoff to Smith. We've been impressed by how nimble Spade can
play and anticipate that pressure.
Play action on second down. Spade retreats. It's a screen. And Smith makes the first man miss. He'll be knocked down by Grandma Jump. Wolverines in borderline field goal range for Allen, needing a couple yards here. A rollout and a throw far side and wide open. Making the catch there is Grant Perry, who's been involved. And catches all season coming in, featured in this first half. Three catches. Approaching the final minute of the half. Play action again. Spade over the middle, in the traffic. Catch made by Darbo, and the Wolverines knocking on the door. Situations for Ohio State. First down throw, and it's Darbo making the catch. A flag comes out after the pass was delivered. Catch was to the two. Penalty moves it a yard closer. First and goal. Smith stacked up, and the Ohio native spun down for handoff inside. Fullback fighting. Hill doesn't get in, and now the clock ticking down to 10 seconds. Michigan will have to spend the football. Hill again, pure power football, muscles in for the maize and blue. And Michigan reclaims the lead 6 seconds before halftime, and it gets feisty down there. Look out, all those big bodies colliding and tempers flaring.
So, I mean, Michigan, Jim Harbaugh is out there, he's involved trying to get guys off the field. His reaction said it all. I mean, it's not just a touchdown to give Michigan the lead. It's an attitude that Michigan prides itself on now with Jim Harbaugh as a head coach.
An attitude and a big body as Hill runs for his 8th 1-yard plunge. It's his 10th rushing touchdown by Barrett in the first since the Wisconsin game. Wolverines trying to build the lead, take over at the 42. Spade from an empty backfield, flips it short, and the catch is made by tight end Butt, who's been official ducking down to keep that passing lane open. Chris Evans in the game, out of the I formation, hands it off, and Evans shows that shake and that acceleration on a first down.
N-O, O-H-N-O gesture.
It's never appreciated, but you make a play and a kick return that set up the touchdown. Now the interception on third and short. Smith gets free, gets the edge. Davion Smith rumbling down inside the 10-yard line. After being bottled up in the first half. Smith again. Picks his way up the middle. Lowers the head. Knocked down at the 1-yard line. Blown out at home last year by Ohio State. Fumbled exchange. And now a scrum at the 2-yard line. Buckeyes are pointing their way, and they have it. A turnover that could turn around this game as Spate fumbled the exchange and Hamilton makes the recovery.
Jim Harbaugh has got to be so frustrated. One thing as a quarterback, when the right guard's pulling around, there's a tendency to want to pull out a little sun. It looked like he actually had his hands on the football. It wasn't as if he was pulling out too early. Ball just never quite. Who's never quite able to secure it. You can see a great effort there by Devon Hamilton, the freshman, who ends up coming up with.
Will he pay the price? Smith, the first down carry, spun, but still fights. And muscles ahead for about 5 in that situation. Peppers in the game. And Wildcat quarterback. Keeps all the way and is again knocked down. Hasn't been a productive formation for them at all. Draymond Jones was there. And Jordan making a huge play. But Wolverines need five on third down. Spate gets rid of it, and a first down completion. Amara Darbo inside.
Rhythm and timing, and there it was perfectly on display.
Again, the Wolverines in a goal-to-go situation. Spate stumbles as he reaches back to hand it off to Smith, who gets just
10-yard line. They've been very good at preventing teams from getting into the end zone.
Hill and Smith in the backfield, but Spate drops back, looks in the flat, and delivers it in a touchdown. Khalid Hill has been a power runner all season long, makes his second touchdown reception. And
Will Spate, I think Spate's going to respond.
Peppers is at tailback. First time he's lined up there today. They fake it to him. Spate rolls out. Darbo's in the flat running free. A well-designed play with the attention perhaps on number five.
Around and use a lot of the misdirection.
It was an 8-yard game. Higdon in the game on second down. He's got it, and he's got a first down.
Best runs, but definitely not feeling it today throwing the ball at this point in the game.
On second down, they hand it off inside to Chris Evans. Michigan's been pretty one-dimensional today. Not much of a running
for times.
And Ohio State's defense get the football back. Spate got pressure, and the ball got deflected at the line. He hits the deck and is a little slow to get up. Tyquan motioning back Smith to the tailback position. They fake it to him. Spate wanted to take a downfield shot. Hit as he throws. Pressured there by Lewis again. Higdon is the back on second and 10. Draw. Cannot escape. Just could not break the tackle of Raekwon McMillan. The top game on third and 10 for Ohio State. Buckeyes rush for Spate, immediately pressured and sacked. Bosa and Jalen Holmes combine.
Luke Fickell mixes it up. His looks, he's showing pressure. They're going to blitz, right? They're going to blitz? No, they're going to drop. And Bosa ends up getting home. Show pressure, drop it. And that's just Nick Bosa with quick hands and quick feet getting right by the veteran Kyle Kalis.
And big brother Joey made a big play against Michigan. Michigan with 7 minutes to go back on offense. It's been tough. Michigan moving around a whole bunch of big bodies pre-snap here on second and 8. Smith running behind all of them and is knocked down after a gain. Gives Spate a chance to move the sticks with a pass. Buckeyes rush four, incomplete. It was thrown a little bit behind Darbo off his head.
Crowd and adversity affected.
Play action in the flat. Jake Butt knocked out at the 16. Smith knocked down. The spot will be a chance here. We got two plays to get a half yard. Well, they hand it straight ahead, and Smith bounds down inside the 10, first and goal, Michigan. Smith cuts it back, fights just inside the 5. It has been a big struggle down here in tight for the Wolverines today.
Leave their corners out there on islands at the bottom.
Spate looks in the flat and delivers incomplete. He fired it low for Hill. Never had a chance.
Now, that was a touchdown pass earlier to Hill. The exact same throw where they kind of snuck him out of the backfield. Linebacker Worley lost him on the touchdown and this time had better coverage. But the throw never really had a chance.
Two plays to get 5 yards to stay alive.
I'm Michigan. I'm anticipating pressure. You're thinking about the blitz here.
Smith, not much. It'll come down to one final play from the five. This is it. Spate across the middle. Touchdown! Darbo went down low. There was hesitation on the call. What a catch by the senior who's dropped a couple. Spate wants to go for two in the win right here.
Ball is thrown low, Chris, but he gets his hands underneath it to secure that for a touchdown. He got away from Lattimore. The ball was thrown low. And Darbo gets underneath to make the catch.
He said he's had a couple of drops. Would have been difficult catches, but no mistake here. Just caressing that football before it hit the ground. And there was some lobbying being done by the quarterback. He was holding up two fingers saying, let's go for two in the win, which, remember, is what Mark D'Antonio chose to do in regulation last week against Ohio State. Came up short.
Yeah, they're going to go for the extra point, it appears anyway. But we're talking a lot about Dark.
End around. Chesson just not able to break the tackle clean. Second and five. Smith into a clogged middle, picks up only a couple. McMillan again tackled him. Third six tackles
19,
in this game.
1986.
Third and four. Spate has time, delivers, incomplete. And well defended by Conley. It's fourth down.
Wow, that is a good throw and a big-time play by Garyon Conley, turning his body around Perry to get the left hand there to knock it away. There's the right arm holding on to that right arm of Perry. The officials do not see that.